Now, our next guests have been at the forefront of British jazz for something like 40 years. Their relationship is often singled out as one of the most innovative, successful and enduring collaborations in show business. Their distinctive style has won them millions of fans around the world, and I know you'll give a huge welcome back to Dame Cleo Laine and John Dankworth. John, I want to talk about your book on jazz that you've just written, partly your life on jazz, but just before we do that, it would be very remiss of me if I didn't mention Frank Sinatra, because I know that you've both worked with him, and obviously so many people worldwide devastated at the news that he's died. So when exactly did you work with him?
Well, twice. There was a very early experience.
In the 60s,
I can't remember very well, because I was frightened of him. And
truly frightened.
Yes, and I avoided him. But John, it was where was it? You remember?
The Festival Hall. But the Albert Hall in 1992. We did a whole week with Frank there, and crossed his path a lot and got to know him quite well.
Yeah, did he actually stop to chat very much?
Oh yes, he came. Every night we used to meet up and have a little chin wag about how the concert was going, and the very first night he came to my dressing room and he said, you ready for this? Because we're going to do a week together. And I said, well, sure I am, yes, I feel very good and very confident. And he said, I don't. He said, I haven't sung for a week. And I thought, well, that's not very long, really. It's very nice not to sing for a week, quite honestly. And I said, well, really and truly, I said, you haven't got any worries, Frank. All you have to do is go out onto that stage, stand there like that, and they'll rise, and you won't have to sing a note.
I'm not so sure about it. I don't think that was very good advice.
It was very good advice.
From a musician's point of view, was he just the best? I mean, so much has been said about him.
He was wonderful, because he knew... I'm an arranger as well, and he knew how to use arrangements, like very few singers do. You know, he'd... Present company accepted, of course.
Of course.
He knew where to sing. An arranger's got to guess where a singer's going to stop and put in a little loopy-doop, you know, in the middle. And some singers roughshod over that, you know, and make a mess of the whole arrangement. But he used to stop, wait for the band, and let them have a little 2 seconds go, and then he'd come back again. But he loved musicians. He idolised musicians. And he stuck with the same musician, same drummer. Cutler was with him, I don't know, 48 years or something, until he passed away. So he always gave them very real credit for what they were worth.
Well, now I want to talk about your mutual career, really.
Because... You want to talk about my book,
oh,
don't
you?
You
don't tell me you're going to hold it up.
Actually, wants to talk about
I want to read from it in a minute, because a little quote that I want. First of all, I would love to talk about your love of jazz from, you know, from both points of view. So were you born into a family that appreciated jazz?
Well, I was in a family that appreciated music and they tolerated jazz. But when I actually started getting interested in jazz, I wasn't sure what was dance music and what was popular music or pop music and what was jazz. But I got to hear a little bit. And then during the war, living in my household was my Aunt Nell. Now, she was a real character, you know, really before her time, you know. She played the trumpet and played the cornet.
Did she?
The French horn, the viola. And to get experience in the cornet, she played it. She joined the local Salvation Army band, because she was the only woman at that time in the band. Used to march along there with her bonnet on and all
Fantastic.
That. Then she came home, and I said, I'm interested in jazz, but I feel it's my mum doesn't like it, and is it any good? You know, I was self-doubt. And she said, oh, of course there's such a thing as good jazz. Look at Louis Armstrong, he's wonderful, you know, got fantastic lips, you know, he can play the trumpet much better than I ever could. And she said, there's Benny Goodman as well. She was telling your mum about Benny Goodman. He plays the classics as well as jazz. So, really, I heard about that. I thought, well, Benny Goodman's my guy. So I rushed down to the local record shop and I found a record of Benny Goodman playing playing T for Two.
And with you, Claire, was it an instinctive thing with you?
It wasn't really. I mean, because my father was black, I listened to black artists quite a lot, and most of them, I guess, were jazz artists, like Louis and Ella and Billie Holiday. And I was a film fanatic, and we used to go to... I love musicals. So I used to go to these, and there were all these artists that appeared in these musicals. So I guess it was because of my father and and films, love of films, that I had an ear for it, but I couldn't say that I understood it any more than most people.
I know. Well,
and then my agent, who was being pestered by a young man who was Cleo's agent, she was unknown at the time, phoned me and said, there's a woman in my office that wants to be a singer. Can I send her around for an audition? So I said, go on, I'll take her off your hands. You know, come, send her around and I'll tell her to go back and practice. And she came and she sang, and it's all in the book. What happened then?
£7 a week. But people always talk about this incredible relationship, not only on stage but off. If you had to put it down to one thing in terms of making it all work as a personal relationship, what would you say it is?
Well, first of all, you have to have a long, thin house so that you can get one can get at one end and one can get the other when you're having a row. And two bathrooms is
two bathrooms. That's the secret, is it?
It really is.
I think two bathrooms, definitely. Whenever we have to share a bathroom, it's punch-up
time. The sparks fly.
Well, I think it's wonderful, not only your success, but also the success of your family, your daughter, your son, very much established. And for the moment, ladies and gentlemen, would you thank Cleo and John for me very much indeed?